Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 8 of my modded Minecraft 1.7.2 Let's Play. And today, again, I have been quite busy, but I have something very cool again to do this episode. So, pretty much between the episode, I have been working on getting myself a couple of things to actually get working on what I want to do this episode. But before I'll tell you guys about that, I quickly want to show you this. I upgraded some of my chests, which is quite cool. Down here, I prettied this up. I'm not sure if I did this between the episode or in the last episode, but I believe I did it between them. So yeah, that's quite cool. The only issue that I do currently have is that the dimensional anchors mod is currently a bit messed up for me. So it's not completely loading the nether, or the overworld for that matter, even when I'm in the nether and not in the overworld. So that means that my lava generation is not completely functional yet. Only I need to travel to the nether once in a while. But for now, it's okay. Then also I made myself these two very cool tools made of manilium. Basically I went to the nether, mined myself a bunch of cobalt and ardite, and created these two tools, which is quite awesome. So yeah, that's what I've been up to. So let's see, first thing that I need to make is a bunch of these power cables. And let's see, so what I want to make for this episode is some automatic farms. I think it's about time to get a bit more automation going in my Minecraft world. So yeah, why not now, I guess. Let's see, I need 4 diamonds for this. So, need to turn these into this stuff. 4 of these. I will be making 2 farms, pretty much. Do I got some more fence thingies? I do, actually. Awesome. So, let's see. Then get 2 of these. I need 2 basic capacitors, which I also got. Then I need 2 diamond hoes. Shouldn't be too difficult to get either. There we go. And now, let's see. Should be able to put this thing together. No, wait. I need the electrical steel. These 2 go here. No. These 2 go here. And this goes there. Yeah! Farming station. Awesome. If you guys haven't checked this block out, you really have to, because it's just quite cool, actually. Cooler than you would expect from something, you know, not too difficult. And hey, Mr. Zombie, and do I got my sound down completely? Oh, yes, I do. Shouldn't have it down completely. That's annoying if I don't have it on a little bit. So let's see. I should have a little prepared area, which I did. I also cleared this out a bit, so that's quite cool. So let's see, one farming station I would like to have right there, and the other sitting right there. Cool. So now I need to add these things to a power list. Well, a power list, I basically hook them up to a power system, so I guess I can do that best underground. So let's quickly tunnel through here and get some... I am completely out of torches, really? Wow. Oh, and it's nighttime anyway, so might as well sleep. I'll meet you guys in a sec. That's a bit better. Okay, so let's see. Quickly meet my pickaxe. It's actually also a quite fast pickaxe, so that's quite cool. And I should be able to see the hole when I'm here. Not quite. Where do I need to go? Oh, well, there we go. let's see, I can pretty much hook up these cables like this. Shouldn't be too hard, actually. Cool. And then probably go... Oh, wow. This is... Wow, that's like a perfect spot. Almost. Though I do need to be on the other side, actually, from the capacitor bank and not directly to the power generation part. So, need to route a little bit around it. So, let's see. Shouldn't be too difficult anyway, so. And just like that, they should be. Yes, they're getting power. Awesome. That means I've finally done something correctly the first time. quickly cover this all up, so no mobs can spawn in here. Oh well. Cool. And also on this thingy. So pretty much how these things work is, first of all, they will need the appropriate tools to make this work. So first thing I will get is probably some seeds and a diamond hoe in this case. And probably also a chest might be good. So just for now it's normal chest, but yeah. Eventually I will probably upgrade it anyway, so cool. And a diamond hoe. Cool. Put it in there. And I need to expand the grass fields just a little bit. I believe this should be big enough. Take this out. And get some grass or some dirt. Cool. So my idea was, for now, to basically use three of these slots for seeds. And as you guys can see, it is currently planting it, so I do need to manually add some water to this. Where do I want to add that? I guess I can put it there and get one more bucket. Or actually, maybe even a bit more. Let's see. Yeah, also adds one, let's say, right there. Now what I want to do is use the other side for growing sugarcane. So pretty much what I will do is break these blocks and probably this. And then, well, get out. For just one sec, make myself an infinite water pool. Set infinite water pool. Cool. And then put the sugarcane in the remaining slots. Hey, it's planting them. Awesome. So now I should be pretty much already ready with this. So if I would put a chest on top of it, I believe. Oh, wait, I can make it automatically output anyway. Cool. So I can push it to the top chest for now. Simply as that. And let me... Oh, oops. Oh well, doesn't really matter. It will auto-replace it anyway. Let me quickly get some bone meal. Just to try it all out. Bone meal. And quickly put all this stuff away anyway. Pretty much what I want to do is have this one set up just for these crops, and then have one set up for trees, which I think will be quite cool actually. So, farm some of these. And hey, it's actually working. And I'm getting more seeds. Cool. So, yeah. Now pretty much what I will do is do kind of the exact same setup right here, but with trees in that case. So, yeah. I think this will be good. And yeah, as you guys can see, it is currently getting the the wheat, and it's damaging the diamond hoe. So yeah, that's cool. So I'll meet you guys in a sec. Okay, so there we go. Let's see if this works. Put a X in this thingy and some saplings. And it's planting them. Awesome. So let's see if it also works with the harvesting of this thingy. Awesome. Configure this thing to automatically push. Oh, this is just awesome. Really, like, just as simple as that. You plant trees, this thing will automatically harvest them for you. It does use the durability of this axe though, so I do need to sometime replace it in the future. But, you know, just for this, it's just epic. I'm actually kind of excited about this. So, yeah. Now what I want to do is basically get a system to pretty much distribute the items from this very quickly into, let's say, some barrels or something sitting right here. So I kind of got an idea for that already, which shouldn't actually be, you know, too difficult, just a cool idea. So what I will need is some barrels. is one of the things that I will need, of course. Sorting barrels, oak barrels. Don't I got normal barrels? Ah, yes. Chest and a lot of wood. Luckily, I got myself a bunch of wood in here, so. Yeah, let's just get a bunch of this stuff. Let's see. Let's say for now, make a ton of barrels, because I know I will be able to use them anyway later on. So let's see, 8 barrels, sure. So then what I want to get is a new tech mod. Well, I wouldn't actually call it new, but I haven't messed around with it in this series, which is, let's see, if I can scroll through this thingy and find it maybe. And if not, I will clearly have to search for it in a different way. One sec. There we go. The mod that I want to get into is Steve's Factory Manager. Steve's Factory Manager is pretty cool, and basically it allows you to automate stuff having to do with machines and transportation and things very easily, more or less like a computer styled system. But it's actually quite interesting how it works and all. So yeah, time to get into this. So do I still got some pistons made somewhere before? I thought I did, but I could be wrong. Apparently I'm wrong. Of course. Then also need some cobblestone, and what other stuff did I need? Some gold and redstone, got that on me. Some smooth stone. Cool. So let's see. First thing we'll need is, let's make 2 of these. Just because I will probably need some more later on anyway. So, might as well have some on me. And then I need some weighted pressure plates. Make 32 of these, I guess. Cool. So, let's do this. What I will make now is, I need a place to actually store all this stuff, and I was thinking simply breaking into this wall. So basically, this will be my wall of barrels, pretty much. And then I can leave this for now, because I don't have enough barrels. But yeah, I think that will be cool. And let me very quickly sleep through the night, because that will save me a bit of monsters and rain and all that annoying stuff. Like these zombies. Oh wow, that had a huge knockback effect. So let's see. What I want to do, probably, is get up here. How would I want to connect these two together? Because I think if I want to do it directly on the side of this chest, then it will be interfering with, with the sapling growth right here. But yeah, technically I don't think that's really a massive issue for me anyway, so die zombies. Sadly this does not look too great, but yeah. Okay, this looks awful. let me quickly reroute this different way. Maybe I can do this from the top on. So let me do this. Go up a bit, then all around this. Cool. And then again, this chest connected to these cables. Then what I can do is simply run the, this is the middle, right? Yes, it is. So I can pretty much run them down there. And then perhaps I can go on the ground with this. I'm really using way too much cables for this, but yeah. I really need to make some more, actually. I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. I know for now it looks absolutely horrible, but don't worry, I will pretty much use some camouflage blocks to make all of these look like stone bricks. So yeah, it'll be, you know, okay looking in the end. So what I can do is pretty much put a controller somewhere. I guess, you know, I could put it like right here in the middle. I think that's not an issue. So yeah, pretty much I need to program this thing like a computer. So basically I will make it a trigger. So let's say a trigger interval every, you know, 5 seconds on interval. Then take items out, or basically into the computer or into the factory manager from inventories. Why am I not seeing? Oh yeah, wait. Also connected to these ones, of course. Also important, just like that. Input from these two chests. Then pretty much all items, the top side, blacklist any items, otherwise it will only take out the whitelisted items. Create output. Inventories, let's say, what barrels do I actually need to target? Okay, this is not really, well, it's a bit useful. So I need, I can select this one, I guess. And this one. It's a bit annoying to actually see this because otherwise I need to mess around with coordinates. So let's see, all the ones that are at X 462 and 461. So it should be a bit easier. 462, 460. 460, 462, and 460. Targets can be top side and blacklisted items. So if I set it up correctly, now they should be able to pull the items from the thingies and into the barrels. Hey, wow, really? Did I make it work? Wow. That's actually quite cool. So let's see, if I would get some more, oh wait, why do I even need bone meal? I got the watering can. I absolutely forgot that I got this one. So let's see, if I would grow some trees, this should make it a little bit easier. And it's automatically cutting it anyway, as you guys can see, so that's great. So how many wood do I got right now? I guess I should be able to see 50 pieces of oak log, okay? So then in a few trees worth of cutting down, I should have a lot more. 67, awesome. So that means it is actually working. Cool. So now this will also make this a little bit easier because I can simply move all my wood to this chest, which is awesome. And all my sugarcane and wheat to this chest. And apples and such will also be generated in that one. Awesome. So yeah, this is actually quite cool and a basic idea on how to automate farms and transportation of it. I know I pretty much made it a little bit too complicated with all these, you know, the factory manager stuff. I could simply use, you know, some type of cables. But, you know, what's the fun in using that? I mean, now I can actually program stuff and perhaps in the future add more farms. And that will be a lot easier simply hooking up more factory manager cables probably. So yeah, I think that will be cool. So I'll be right back. So yeah, what I will probably do now is also get working on a little mob farm. You know, I should have still one more ender pearl left. So I should be able to make myself the golden lasso. Ender pearl for string. Really? 3 pieces of string? Wow, that's just the game mocking me. Wow, that's just sad actually. Then what I will do is, what should I do? I mean, I don't think that for this episode I got much else planned. It's actually got this made a little faster than I actually expected it to. So I guess I will cut this episode right here. Maybe it's a little bit short, 20 minutes. Sorry if not a little bit longer, but I think that if I would keep it around 20 minutes, more people will be able to enjoy it, because if videos are starting to go to more like 30, 35 minutes, people will get bored very easily and not watch it completely. So yeah, that's why I try to keep my episodes a little bit... Wow, random creeper, which I did not hear. So that's why I will keep my episodes a little bit less long. So yeah, hope you guys don't mind. So yeah, like I said, this is Scorch signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. So yeah, thanks for watching. Please leave a rating. Be sure to follow me on my social media. And I hope to see you guys all next time.